एक्सेल फॉर्मूला एंड और वीबीए, बिकॉज द रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ दैट डाटा इज टू बी डन विद चार्ट्स एंड द चार्ट्स विल गेट डेटा फ्रॉम अ प्लेस वेयर वी हैव डन ऑटोमेशन सच एज इन दिस लिस्ट आई वॉन्ट टू शो टॉप 10 स्कोर पर्सन द पर्सन हु हैव स्कोर्ड इन टॉप 10. So when I enter a value, it will dynamically update that. If I enter again a value, it's 105. It will come at. It will evaluate automatically. So this concept is used in our dashboard. So let us do some easy work by creating a speedometer chart. Let's see, there are lots of tricks available on net on these topics, such as these pie charts, speedometer chart, beer jug chart. So there are lot of tricks available on YouTube. You can check it out. But today I am going to show you speedometer chart. How to create a chart like speedometer. So for this, let me show you my speedometer to you first. Basically, this is the speedometer chart. I have attached with the control and it is running. It's actually a combination of two charts. And I have graphically designed this too much. This line is from pie chart. And this is from donut chart. Rest all things are graphically designed. So let us see what we do for creating this. First we have our areas, which will be red, yellow and green. These three areas will be there. I put some values here. Twenty, 40 and again 20. Or we can say 30 here and 30 here. So it is 100. The total value is here. So what we're going to create, if we create a pie chart or donut chart in this table, we will create a donut chart. So here you can see we have three areas separated and one full half area. बिकॉज वी हैव टेकन द टोटल ऑफ ऑल दीज थ्री आइटम्स, सो इट वुड बी हाफ, सो दैट्स वाई इट इज क्रिएटेड लाइक दिस. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू, आई हैव टू टर्न दिस टेबल, रोटेट दिस चार्ट. आई गो टू फॉर्मेट डेटा सीरीज एंड गिव्स रोटेशन हेयर. टू सेवेंटी फाइव. नॉट 270 degrees. On 270 degrees. Now what I will do, I will select this area and make it invisible. No fill. I don't want to see that. Now I don't need this legend entry here. I have a donut chart only. I just go to format chart area, no fill and no line. What I get here, only a speedometer type, a base of a speedometer here. But see how we will do through pie chart, because this one, how it is moving. What we have created, we have taken the total of here, we have taken all 200, because I have to make a chart parallel to this. This gauge should be moved from here this end to this end, not in a down direction. So the same trick I will follow here. Here I have 100. So first value, maybe anything. And this gauge, the value I do for gauge, or whatever it is, it will be 100 minus this plus this. So in this, this will creating all 100. Okay. Now I will create a chart here, pie chart. I don't need this legend. But I have taken, I should use here, not 100, 200, because the total of them is 200. So I need, I think, 200 here. What I will do, I will rotate this chart to 270 degrees and make it invisible, this area. See what is happening here. The first value, I will link this value to anything else. When I will increase this value to 20, it moves to 20, because the area increases, this one decreases. The gauge is always same. This is the thickness of this gauge. If you increase, it will increase. So I can make it to 1, but in 1 it is not visible clearly, so I make it to 2. So what I will do this, I will just make it invisible, this one and this blue one invisible. Format chart area, no fill. Border, I don't need border. So I have a chart again. I just have to make it in center of this one. So when I just change this color to black. Format data point, fill, solid fill, black, so that it could be visible. So when I change this value to 30 or any, it is moving, and at last I have told you that user controls. If I use my user control as a scroll bar, I can format this control. The value can be 1. The minimum value will be 1. Maximum 2, it can go to 98. Incremental change 1, or maybe we can a change of 10. We get the cell link, okay, and when we move it down, shows us the increment. Now just do some color formatting, because I have changed gauge color but not here. Format data point, this is for red, this one is for yellow, and this one for green. This is a simple speedometer chart. See, where can we use this type of thing? Once we have created this thing, then we know that it is showing the share only. So the total share will be here, the 50% of this total, or this one, the total value will be of total sales. You can put here and you can distribute in percentage 30, 40 or 30% as per your areas, these areas, and you can make a gauge by double your sum and this one will be remain same. Here your full value will be running. So these two points will be linked with data. So we can make it attractive through various graphic options. We can use oval to make look like a real speedometer, like this one, एंड वी कैन मेक द आउटलाइन मोर बोल्ड बोल्ड इन एनी अदर कलर और इन एनी अदर ग्लो. Make it like this. Turn to back. So graphically you can control this thing. So there are a lot of more options. One thing more, I was showing the values here. So what I have done for that, I have just inserted a shape from here. Whatever I want to write, I set a font here in this to something large, bold, and whatever I done, go to this formula bar, press equal to and choose your cell from here plus this one. So their value it will show. I just changed some design here. Like this, I have shown value. When you change it, it will show the value here. So these type of gauge you can build for your dashboards. Now let's see to this chart. There is a concept built in. See what happens here. When we create a dashboard, we want dynamic updation. The things can be done automatically. So here we have some data, some score type of data. Now we want top 10 here, the list of top 10 scorers. See what is the problem here? The score can be duplicate. So getting the right data somewhere not possible here. So how we will get the exact data, exact score? We want here top 10. So first thing we will do, for dynamic updation of this table, we need to select this data and do one thing. Either we can press Ctrl T for creating this data as a table, or we can go in Home tab and format as table we can choose. So it will make it as a table. Now when you click on this table, you will see here table tools and design. Here you can change your table name. I set it to DT. This is serial. Okay. So DT. Now when I am referring to this, referring this one here, so how will I do that? For getting the largest value, we can use our large formula. This large formula takes an array, and the k is the position of that position, largest position in that array, such as first largest position, second largest position. So in array we will give this score. So score, our table name was DT. When you press this bigger bracket, you will see the headings here. So you can select the heading. We require score here. When we type this, it will automatically select this range. And K, let me take from here. I just copy down this formula. So I have 10 largest values. Now we need names here. We can use index match, because on the basis of score we have to find these names. In VLOOKUP we can find only left to right. Right to left we can't find. So we have index match formula for that. Index, what is to be find here? So I need these names, the value in these names. So I need DT name, bracket close, comma. Now it is asking for row number, from which row number you want. I will match it from my score table here. The lookup array will be again DT. This score to be looked up in this score table. So score here. And for exact match we press 0. Our formula is there. Drag it here.
If suppose two persons have the same score, then how it will can, yeah. You just make it 105 for the other one,
it will show the same name. But I will tell you that, tell you the solution after that, because it would be great confusion there. I have done in, yeah, in my first sheet I have done this thing. If you put here the same as 75, so you will find both the names here, Ravi Kabir, Ravi Kabir. So I will tell you how to do that. So first we have here a dynamic data. If the value degrades, it will never ask. It will automatically change. So basically we are creating chart on this table only, which is dynamically updating. Generally we don't put that data together, we just put our charts somewhere else in some dashboard like thing. Or we hide this data. We just enter the data. And you will find here. Now you can see this category is also in reverse order. We want in reverse order because the top list should be like this, but it is taking the last one first. So just go to format data series and no, go to axis and in axis category in reverse order. Now it is right. Format data series, we just reduce the gap. And we can have our data labels here with the values. Or in bar chart we have another option, infill, vary colors by point, different colors, sorry. So let's see the problem of. Now the chart is ready. When we reduce the value, it updates automatically. So let's see how to survive our unique values. First we need to create a formula here. In agent cell of our data, that this value plus in brackets this one divided by 1 lakh or something crore. What will happen here? By this logic, the values you can see here are same, but actually what happened here, I paste somewhere in fresh area. Here is the change. You can see.
Yeah.
Because I know by dividing by 1 crore or 1 lakh, it has no effect with our original values. It just put a small value behind behind these decimals. So what will happen, our value will be unique, okay? If there are duplicate values such as 75, 75 has preceding पॉइंट जीरो 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 थ्री एंड अनदर 75 इफ वी हैव अनदर 75 हेयर सो इट विल टेक 0.0004 सो आवर वैल्यू इज यूनिक नाउ ओके सो यूनिक वैल्यू फ्रॉम दिस यूनिक वैल्यू वी कैन फाइंड आवर ओरिजिनल नेम्स सो वट वी नीड टू डू दैट इंस्टीड ऑफ दिस स्कोर वी नीड टू फाइंड वट दिस कॉलम कॉलम वन So we have this type of values which we are finding side as an extra. Now the actual score will come through index and match. What we have to find here is score. So in array we will take score and row number will be find right from match lookup value will be the side one and the lookup array will be this dt and this value to be looked up in this column so column 1 and 0 for exact match close the bracket now you get the actual value here and the same formula we need for name here we need to change instead of score we'll find name There are some values are mistaken here, so just dragging this. Now it has a solution for duplicate. Now just make lot of 75s. It will show every name. Okay, sir.
Yeah.
So this is your basic chapter. We will today, tomorrow do some advanced things. So just
yeah.
Practice sure. on this our
yeah.
Speedometer chart and this concept. Okay, sir.
Sandeep sir, can you able to spare 2-3 minutes?
Yes, sir.
I have one question. Yeah, I have one question.